She's strong, but with great, great heart. And I want to thank you for an outstanding job.
I've loved every minute, even the hard minutes. I have loved it.
Sarah Huckabee Sanders is stepping down as White House press secretary after a tumultuous tenure that included many clashes with reporters.
Come on, Sarah, you're a parent. Don't you have any empathy for what these people are going through? These people have nothing.
Hey, Brad, I know you want to get some more TV time, but that's not what this is about. I want to recognize you.
Molly, it's a no-win job caught between the president and an antagonistic press corps. We kind of got a hint of that there. She's taken a lot of personal abuse, but many journalists have been critical of how she's handled the job.
Right. I cannot imagine what a difficult position she's in to have such a non-traditional president and how to convey and explain his positions. And then usually Republican press secretaries, press secretaries for Republican presidents have a difficult time, but it's unlike anything we've seen in the past couple of years. But she had to manage both of those very difficult, challenging situations.
Susan, Sarah Sanders will be remembered as the press secretary who presided over the demise of the Daily Press. We haven't been one for more than 3 months, but that's not really her decision. The president, her boss, decided he'd rather talk to reporters virtually every day than have any staff member out there briefing.
Right. He is in control of his own message to the media. He talks to them every day on Twitter. He talks to the press constantly on South Line before he gets on the helicopter. Mm-hmm. He's always communicating, making it impossible to have sort of this very congruous relationship with your own media staff, because you conflict with them all the time, and then they're portrayed as liars. Really a no-win. And so I wonder whoever succeeds him, if they can be successful any more than Sarah Sanders.
Whoever succeeds Sarah Sanders, yeah. Sarah Sanders, her reputation, I would say, took its biggest hit over what happened after Jim Comey was fired, and she told reporters that she'd heard from countless members of the FBI that they're grateful for the president's decision. She later told Bob Mueller's investigators that that wasn't true. It was a slip of the tongue, a heat of the moment, and she got beat up by the press for not expressing any regret.
Yeah, I think what I will give her a point for is she's had a tough job, right? She's had a president who sort of created his own news. He's on Twitter and she's in the briefing room and it's happening simultaneously, so that has to be tough. But where I think that, you know, this White House can have some improvement in this job if they decide to go back to daily press briefings is telling the truth, number one. And number two, and more importantly, is really figuring out how this president's going to communicate with the White House press corps, being that there is a press briefing room. Are you just going to get rid of press briefings altogether, or are you just sort of going to have them show up every day and say, no briefing today?
Well, we see how he communicates. He communicates on the run, on the fly, in these so-called pool sprays in the Oval Office. But some journalists really offering harsh assessments after the news. Let's take a quick look.
I will not miss her after she departs the White House.
We were the first hour to ban her her tape, and so I literally and figuratively will not miss her either.
She suffers from liabetes, and her tenure has been fraught with sex, lies, and videotape.
Journalists kicking her on the way out the door.
And excellent choices of a couple journalists to look at there. These are people who say the most horrible things against Sarah Sanders, all while they have had major troubles with their own journalism. And just a larger situation with our press corps of them not telling stories accurately, not reporting things accurately, not thinking about what the major stories are of the day. I do think we have a major problem with truth-telling in this country and that everybody could improve on it, but we absolutely need to see better behavior by the press corps.
Maybe they would report stories more accurately if there was more press briefings in the White House actually released accurate information, which Sarah Sanders admitted to not doing.
But you touched on something, which is, you know, the president might say something for which there's no evidence or is exaggerated or is perhaps untrue, and then you're the press secretary and you're getting pounded. And in every administration this goes on, the press secretary wants to defend the boss without personally vouching for someone something that may or may not be true, that you don't personally know whether it's true.
And I think that's the hard part of the job. What makes this different is in the Mueller report, she literally admits to saying, no, I just sort of made that up.
Okay, in fairness, that was one instance, and she told the New York Times magazine in a piece that just came out that being a liar certainly bothers me. And Sarah Sanders said there's a difference, in her view, between misspeaking or not knowing something and then maliciously lying, just briefly.
And I'll just make this one point. In that 2014 Fox poll, 81% of respondents said that they believed President Obama lied at least some of the time on important matters. So this idea that there are lies only coming from the Trump administration and not other past administrations, complete bunk.
Little historical context. Richard Fowler, Susan Ferriccio, Molly Hemingway. Great to see you all this Sunday.